Yo people from the IOMAR community to date with City Skylines. So in the last episode we expanded our city and now we have this like empty dam in the middle of our city, which we will use as a kind of a flood barrier for if a tsunami comes, then the water can flow into it and we will have no problem at all. And whoa, hey, what am I looking here? Why doesn't this have a connection? Okay, now it does. But anyways, I was also looking some better tips to get more materials and more products. Well, and there is something called raw materials and natural resources. So we have a bit of forest industry here, which we will use. And if I can upgrade my city to this area, I can make another area for the ores. But I also found out that we have a oil pocket over here, which we can use to get more oil industry. So that is what I want to do today, to get a specific area for the oil, which we'll use there. And I also want to make one location, possibly for fertile land, possibly this large area. Because, yeah, if you can see, this is a bit of fertile area here, it is... somewhere, but it's all filled up already with industry, so those places are not going to be used for that. So I will hopefully be able to make it like here, so we shall see. First things first, let's go and build this road out, because what I will do is make a 2x2 road, since this road possibly won't go way further, so a lot of traffic isn't really going to be there. So let's just give this a nice road up until here. Well, we can always bridge it to this area. What we'll also do is possibly get another harbor in here, just for the industry. Oh yeah, this also has oil. And I think that area will be very polluted. So let's not go and mess with the trees. Okay, let's get this up to here. I won't connect it to this main road up until here. So maybe I can connect this one. Ah, that just not enough. Ugh. I can't do it from here. Something like this. Okay, let's make more roads. Up till here will be good enough. Okay, so this power line might have to go. Oh, or not. How far can this go? This can go to here. Okay. I guess this will do. Why do we have another power line here? Why is that needed? It doesn't make sense to me. Okay, so now let's get the district going. The demand of industry is really low for now. But that doesn't matter much, I guess. Okay, let's go ahead and make this whole island this district. Boom. I'm the island 2.0. Oh, wait. Just to I keep what else would be nice as an island? Maybe just Holy Island. That would be good. Okay, so now we have to select this district and make it the oil district. And now this can be filled up. And of course the demand of it will start to rise soon enough. Of course not yet. Because the demand is really low. But that isn't a problem. Since if they want to build, they can do it whenever they want. Okay, let's just go ahead and fix this up. No. Okay, that's good for now. Yeah, we should also get another harbor in. So let's get rid of this bit of barrier. Get another cargo harbor in here. Yeah, right there. That fits perfectly. You know what we should do? We should have a tunnel goes under here and then back to here. Which means is that we can have a float barrier right here. And water wouldn't come in. That would be fantastic if that works. This will give us a lot of help. Delete this. Okay, I also want to fix the whole water flow. Okay, yeah, there is traffic starting to come around here, just because of the harbor, which is good. Yeah, they seem to come from this industry, which is nice. Look at the plane. Look at this plane. Oh yeah, no, no, there's grass growing here. Oh, nice. That makes it so incredible that that happens over time. And of course, when a tsunami comes, it will start to flood possibly most of these islands. There will be nothing left of them. But at least we have a barrier protecting the most important part of a city. Well, this is also a very important part. It hasn't flooded as much. This part got really hit with it. So I'm glad that we now have a few more barriers for it to, for it to hold, for it to stay away. I mean, what I could do is go ahead and summon a tsunami. So just in case we get a tsunami, we know how to improve on the things that are making it worse. So let's get the severity in from, I guess, 6. So where do I need to put it? A wave is created in the sea and travels towards the city. The severity controls the height of the wave. Depending on the map, it can take quite long for the tsunami effect to be seen. The tsunami has no location. Okay, let's just get it over here. Normally I wouldn't mess with that, since I wanted to fix it by itself. But now I'm like, okay, we have a few defenses ready, so let's see how they work and how efficient they are. It could be a disaster for us. But I want this to work. And if it works, then we know it's good. Of course, you can also see the pollution in the water a bit. But yeah, I don't know when the tsunami will come, but it will come sooner or later. Just not yet. Because when you summon a tornado or something, it immediately happens. But with this, it doesn't. It's really annoying sometimes. We also have a lot of boats here traveling around. And that's very nice that we have that. Maybe we have to get rid of this one. That will make the traffic flow a little bit easier. It won't be way easier is very... Oh. Yeah, then I have to do this, I guess. Let's make the traffic flow one way. So if they go out, they have to go all the way around. They will find a way. It's AI. It's what it's supposed to do. All the roads are being messed with. Okay, no tsunami coming yet. But that's no worries. I see something flying over in the distance. But anyways, I will leave this episode right here. So please leave a like, subscribe to the channel. I will see you next video. Bye!